Tell me, what did I say to apple? What did Mom's quick thinking, the kiss will take place after all. Tomorrow morning at the railroad station, just before Conrad leaves. So it looks like you failed, Rose, as anyone must fail since the Buck Al Peterson. One of the giants, one of the titans, one of the King Kongs of the music industry. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but names will never harm me. You big rat. Sorry, I had to do that in front of you folks, but I've had to let Miss Alvarez go. I'll get that.
Great. It's probably Hong Kong again.
Hello, this is Albert Peterson speaking. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Lewis, but Miss Rose Alvarez is no longer with us. That's right, she...
Miss Alvarez!
And where do you think you're going, young lady?
With Rosie, to drain deep the dregs and sip full-hearted brimming cup, to live.
Upstairs.
But Daddy.
Upstairs. Do you hear me? I said, go upstairs.
Miss Alvarez was right. You're all the same, from Puri to Mussolini.
What was that? You dare say Puri in front of your own father? Not to mention Mussolini. Doris, we failed as parents. I don't ask much from my children. All I ask for was respect, a little bit of respect. That's all I asked for, respect. But did I get respect? I did not get respect. I got no respect!
I respect you, Pa.
I don't want your respect! You're a child! What good is respect from a child? Doris, take me upstairs. I'm not a well man. There were three words I didn't want to hear in this house. Puberty was the first, and Mussolini was the second. And the third was respect!
I'm sorry, Mr. Lewis, but no 3-cent reporter can bulldoze me. I happen to be Albert J. Peterson, and you can print that whatever cheap paper you happen to represent. Oh, it's not a paper, it's a magazine. And it's not Mr. Lewis, it's Mr. Lewis. I need Rosie.
Sonny boy, where are you going?
Oh, nowhere, Mama. It's just stuffy in here, so. No, I'm gonna look for Rosie, Mama. I love her and I want her back.
Is that all? I thought it was something serious.
By all means, Sonny, find your little spade and bring her back here. And by the way, dear, when you get back, be sure to stop in the kitchen, take my head out of the oven, and turn off the gas!
Mama!
Just try and tell someone to run up a bit!
Mama, I've had enough of this. If you really love me, you let me find Rosie before it's too late. Do you realize what's happened? The poor girl's gone out to make up in all the years she wasted on me. Who knows what low dive she's in at this very moment.
Sonny, you're right. I'll help you find her, but I better give you the message from Conrad first.
What message?
Oh, it's nothing to worry about, darling. He's just going out tonight, and he doesn't think he'll be back in time to kiss Kim tomorrow.
What? Why didn't you tell me that before?
Well, I tried to, darling sweetheart, but he kept bringing up a certain party from south of the border.
I don't know what the matter with him is. He knows how much this means to me. Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy. I'm coming. And before you start hollering, Albert, I just want you to know that I made up my mind. I'm tired of getting up at 9 every morning, having people watch me when I eat, and letting kids poke me in the eye. I want to have some fun, go out, meet a couple of young chicks. Don't you understand, Albert? I am tense!
Mama, don't just stand there and do something.
Conrad, have you ever thought in terms of a more mature woman?
Man, I hope I never get that tense. Oh. Now, look, buddy boy. This is my last night out before I go into the army, and I am going out.
You can't leave without my permission. It says so in your contract. Mama, get my contract. It's upstairs in my... You know what? I'll get it. Conrad, you stay right there.
Conrad!
There are chicks just right for some kissing, and I mean to kiss me a few. And those chicks don't know what they're missing. I've got a lot of living to do. Sizzling steaks already for tasting, and there's Cadillacs all shiny and new.
book, Sweet Apple, Ohio, founded in 1852 by Jeremiah S. Apple.
No, what do you do here? Where do you go to have a ball?
Well, there's the church basement and the sweet shop. The older kids go to the ice house.
What's there?
I don't know. Ice, I guess?
It just so happens, Mr. Birdie, that the ice house is where people go when they want to be alone.
Hey, Chibo, check out I'm supposed to kiss.
I am not a chick. I am a fully grown woman, and I insist on being treated as such. As a matter of fact, that's why I'm leaving home.
Now you're talking chick. Come on, let's move. We got things to do. Crazy clothes and motorboat races. Someone nice to cuddle up to.
Tips I got you last Christmas. What are you just standing there for? My daughter's run off with a fiend! Oh, get me a water gun!
Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids. Kids, who can understand anything? Kids, they are disobedient.
I don't mind the moonlight swims, Doris. It's the loop-de-loop that hurts. Kids! Why don't they lower the draft age to about 11?
Kids!
I didn't know what puberty was until I was almost past it.
Kids, they're just impossible to control. Kids, with their awful clothes and their rock and roll. Why can't they dance like we did? What's wrong with Sammy K?
Hey, Pop, here's my pea shooter.
A pea shooter? What good's a... Now, give it to me!
What's the matter with kids today?
It's about Conrad.
And furthermore, even if I were this Rose, which I'm not, the one thing that would certainly make me hang up is any mention of anyone named Conrad.
No, Rosie, please don't hang up. I won't mention Conrad. We'll talk about anything you want. You, me, I, anything. Rosie, please.
Talk to me, baby, won't you talk to me? I don't care what you say, baby, talk to me. Must you go so far away from me? It seems all wrong this way. You miss me, tell me so, are you?
No business of yours, lady. It's a private dining room.
Private for whom?
For men only. That's for whom?
For men only? That is exactly what I'm looking for. I've heard what goes on in these small towns. Out of Spanish roses, woman.
Wait,
lady. Wait, don't let her go in there.
Out loud
wait,
here.
Spanish roses, I'll be right down. Mom,
wait.
Coat.
Power vested in me. Now, for the recording secretary, it's the minutes of last week's meeting. I'd like to talk about a subject that I'm sure is on everybody's mind.
Thank you. bar and get me some green alcohol to go?
Not for $1 million.
The whole world's collapsing before me. I can't get a drink. Kids are open off the car onto the ice house.
Kim and Tanya!
Albert! I have to phone Albert. You go! You go home! Go! Run! I said run!
Wait a minute!
Here it is. Mom's roadside retreat. I'm coming, Rosie! Hurry, Mom!
I don't know why we have to go running around looking for someone. It would be better not to find in the first place. If you listen to me, Sonny, you'll come home, have a nice cup of toast, and we go to bed.
Mama, I told you I'm not coming home until I find Rosie. Now, if you want to leave, that's okay with me. As a matter of fact, it's not a bad idea. Why don't you go home, Mom?
What? Did you say, sweetheart, darling?
I said, why don't you go home, Mom?
Would you mind repeating that once more, Sunshine Pines?
I said, go home. I don't need you anymore.
So, it's come at last. At last, it's come. The day I knew would come at least, it's come. At last, my sunny boy doesn't need me anymore.
McPhee, a great pleasure to see you again. I must tell you that Conrad's affairs no longer interest me. Now, have you seen Salvarez? Could you tell them? Did you say Conrad and Kim?
They run off together.
And if we don't find them soon, I will call the FBI. Who's the head of it out here? Is it Peter Lawford yet?
I'm sure there's nothing to worry about.
Doris, Harry, have you seen Ursula?
Ursula?
Is she missing too?
Since 10 o'clock and I've looked everywhere.
Mr. Peterson!
McPhee, you haven't seen my Harvey, have you?
Or Roger and Phyllis!
They're probably all down at the drugstore, having one of those, gang wars.
Gang wars?!
Another teenage delinquent.
I think the news.
My girl has gone off with Conrad to the movies!
To the movies. Great Deauville tonight. Flying down to Rio and Greed. I'll always remember that great cast. Dolores Del Rio.
And Gene Raymond.
What a score.
I almost forgotten about that.
Albert!
Rosie, where have you been? I've been looking for you all night. I have good news for you, Rose. I did it. I sent Mama home. And I'm a new man, Rose. A world leader.
Albert!
Amy and Conrad have gone to the ice house.
The ice house?
The ice house?! Doris, call the mountain police! And call Mr. King! Trace our lost persons! And don't forget to call the Shadow! Look him under on Mount Cranston!
By 6:30 tomorrow morning, when I intend to be there with Conrad. And I further command you to bring whatever legal documents are necessary, because I intend to make you Mrs. Albert Peterson by 2400 hours tomorrow. Roger, over and out. Rose, did I mention I love you?
Not yet, Albert.
Oh, I do.
A wonderful ride. Then I might be Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Pod Peter Kappa Peterson.
Oh, Rosie, heart, little friend. I will always have time to talk with the woman who by tomorrow I will be able to call.
No tables!
I'll be able to call mother!
The coolest bar I ever heard. To think I'd see the day I'd have relatives in El Salvador.
Not to mention Chile, Uruguay, Brazil, Guatemala, and Chichi Costa Mango. And by the time Albert and I are married, I'm going to stick a gorilla in my teeth, sit in my adobe hut on Central Park West, and sell tortillas. Adios, mama.
Adios, Rosita!
Mrs. Pearson. I'm dispatched to Mali according to Mary. Right off the boat from the tropics far, far away. Which is kind of funny since where I come from is our town today. Spanish! Okay, May, I'll be Spanish right after I'm Manny Alberto. I'll be the toast of Chichi Costa Mango and all day long my castanet. I'll hide behind my fan to drag you on. I'll be so Spanish, it will make you sick. I'll be the tacos and the enchilada. I'll drink tequila till I feel no pain. Oh, the only song I'll sing will be Ronaldo. I'll be more Espanol than Abby Lane.
Thank you.
There's no one here. Come on.
Now, look, Albert.
Shut up and get on that train. It took every cent I had to bail you out, and I don't want you to see until we're out of the state. Now get aboard.
Now, wait a minute, buddy boy. You saved my life, and whether you pay me no guarantee or not, you have a contract with me forever.
What are you saying?
Here's a check I signed my name to, Albert. You just fill in whatever you want.
Hello, Albert.
Mama.
Rose! You look good for a change!
Don't worry, I know all about you too. I won't make a fuss. I'll do what any intelligent mother has to do.
Goodbye, dear. You'll have 3 mink skulls as soon as the train passes over me!
Mama! Get up and get on that train. I have no time for any nonsense.
Mr. Peterson, I demand to know where Conrad Birdie is. He wasn't in that jail cell.
How should I know where he is? I haven't seen him all night. I just came down to the train station to say goodbye, to Rosie.
Mr. Peterson!
Now, there's no point in getting excited, dear. After all, there's no real harm done. Kim and Hugo are back together. And a matter of fact, the sweetest thing just happened. He proposed to her this morning, and she accepted!
No!
Dear, what's wrong?
My life is over! That's what's wrong! If I would just sell the house and put me in an old folks home!
All aboard!
About a minute ago.
Albert, you told me to be here at...
With Conrad.
At 6:30 sharp, I...
And Mama.
Albert, you want us to miss that train?
Well, it stands to reason, Rose. Why get on a train to New York when you're headed to Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
What's in Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
An opening in the teaching staff position of Pumpkin Falls Junior High. I read about it in the morning paper. They're looking for somebody to teach English and domestic science. And I hope you brought your documents, Rose, because they prefer the applicants to be married.
Oh, Albert!
Rosie, did you ever have a more beautiful name? I was never crazy.
Thank you.
Thank you.